everyone, welcome back to the channel. In today's video, we'll see how to create an animated YouTube video using ChatGPT. First, we'll see how to write a script using ChatGPT, and then we'll convert that script into an animated video by adding characters, backgrounds, and voiceovers. After watching this video, you can create animated videos like this.
Today, we're going to take a look at three fascinating facts that you never learned in school. Number 1. Did you know that the Great Wall of China is not visible from space with the naked eye? Despite what many people believe, the Great Wall is not wide or tall enough to be seen from space.
Let me fast forward the preview. Looks cool, right? Let's get started. Here are the steps that we'll be following in this video. Step 1. Creating the script. Open the ChatGPT tool on your browser. Ask ChatGPT to take up a specific role and answer your questions. For that, you have to start your queries with the words "act as." I'm asking the ChatGPT to act as a YouTube title generator and give me some title ideas. Following that, I'm asking it to act as a YouTuber and give me a script on the following topic. Now that we have the script, let's see how to convert it into an animated video. Step 2. Creating an animated character for the video. Open the browser and visit the website www.animaker.com. Now sign up on the website. You will be taken to the dashboard of the application. Select the Create option on the left, followed by selecting Create a Character option. The Character Builder tool will open in a new window. Now select a basic character to begin with. Let's start with the skin tone. Next, we have the hairstyle. Next, we have the face structure, followed by beard style, eyes, eyebrows, nose, and lips. Let's quickly customize these parts. We also have the option to change the attires. There are attires of different professions and cultures. You can customize the top wear and bottom wear separately. Below that, we have the wearable sections such as glasses, hats, shoes. You can create billions of unique looking characters with all these options. Once you are done, save the character using the option at the top. Now click on the dashboard option. Let's create a new video project by selecting the following options on the dashboard. A new project will open in a new window. Let's start with adding the animated character to the scene. By default, you can see the character library open. It has adult male and female characters, plus size characters, animal characters, and kids characters. For this video, we'll be using the custom character that we created earlier. To access that, open the My Character section of the library. Click on the character to add it to the video. The center part where the character appears is called workspace. On the left-hand side, we can see the list of actions that can be added to the character. I want an action in which he seems to be standing with his hands folded. You can also choose an expression for the character. On the timeline, we can see an highlighted part. You can control how long the character will be visible on the scene by adjusting this part. For instance, if I drag the left edge of the bar and keep it around the first second, the character will be visible after the first second. Let's use the preview icon above the timeline and see how this works. As I want the character to be visible throughout the scene's duration, I'm making sure that this bar is present throughout the scene. Step 3. Adding the background. Open the background section of the library. Here you can see the different backgrounds that can be added to the video. For the first scene, I'm selecting an abstract background. Once you click on the background, it will be added to the video. Step 4. Adding the voiceover. As the next step, let's add voiceover to the character. With the character selected, right above the workspace, you can see a set of options. To add voiceover, click on the lip sync option. You will get 3 more options to add voiceover. Using this option, you can directly record your own voice and add it to the character. Click on the record option to record your voice. You can preview the recorded voice, re-record it if you need, and apply it to the video. The next option is to upload a pre-recorded audio file. If you have a voiceover recording that you want to add to the video, you can use this one. Next, we have the text-to-speech option. For this video, we'll be using this option. Let's paste the script from ChatGPT over here. On the right-hand side, we have the option to customize the voiceover. Let's select the gender, language, and a voice for the character. You can preview the voice.
Today, we're going to take a look at 3 fascinating facts that you never learned in school.
You can further make changes to the voice using this option. You can control the speed, pitch, and volume of the voice. You can also add break and breathing effects between words. If you have a paid plan, then you can use this auto-enhance feature and make the voice human-like in a single click.
Today, we're going to take a look at 3 fascinating facts that you never learned in school.
Select the Add to Timeline option to add the voiceover track to the video. You can see the overall timeline with the voiceover track on it. To edit the characters and other elements added to the video, we'll be using the scene timeline. To edit the voiceover and music track added to the video, we'll be using the overall timeline.
Today, we're going to take a look at 3 fascinating facts that you never learned in school.
We can see that the voiceover ends in the 6th second, but the scene continues till the 10th second. By default, the duration of a scene is set to 10 seconds on Animaker, but you can always increase or decrease it using these plus or minus options present over here on the scene timeline. Every time we press the minus icon, the scene duration will be reduced by 1 second. Let's keep the scene's duration to 6 seconds to match the duration of the voiceover. Step 5. Adding illustrations. Open the property section of the library. I'm going to add a light bulb to the scene. We are going to make the illustration appear around the 3rd second. Let's add an animation effect to this light bulb. With the light bulb selected, click on the animation option present above the workspace. Now you can see the list of animation effects on the left hand side. Once you click on the effect, you can see an highlighted part on the timeline. By dragging this, you can control the duration of the animation effect. Let's take a look at the changes we made.
Today, we're going to take a look at 3 fascinating facts that you never learned in school.
Pretty cool, right? Let's add a new scene to the video. To add a new scene, go to the scene section on the right-hand side and click on the plus icon. Now we are going to repeat the step from the scene 1. Let's add the character and select an action for it. Let's add the voiceover to the character. Let's select the background for the scene. Let's reduce the extra duration on this scene. We are going to repeat the same steps and complete the rest of the video. I have created all the scenes. Now there are a few more changes left to complete the video. Let's add a transition effect between the scenes. To add a transition effect, click on the Add Transition option between the scenes. Now you can access more than 50 plus transitions. Let's select one. I'm adding transitions to a few more scenes. Step 6. Adding music. To add a music track, go to the music section of the library. You can use the search option to browse the music tracks. There are more than 30,000 copyright-free music tracks present here. Keep the pointer over a track to preview it. Click on a track to add it to the video. Let's reduce the volume of the music track so that it doesn't overpower the volume of the voiceover track. Do a right click on the music track to open the advanced settings and reduce its volume. To preview all the scenes together, click on the preview option at the top.
Today, we're going to take a look at 3 fascinating facts that you never learned in school. Number 1. Did you know that the Great Wall of China is not visible from space with the naked eye?
To download the video, use the publish option. It will take a few minutes and you will be redirected to the exports page from where you can download the video. Step 7. Adding subtitles. This is the exports page. And here is where you can find all the exported videos. You can download the video by selecting this download option. But if you want to add subtitles to the video before downloading, click on the Add Subtitles button over here. The AI-powered subtitle generator will open in a new window. On the left-hand side, you can see 3 different options to add voiceover. We are going to use the auto subtitle feature. Once you click on it, the AI will take a few minutes to analyze the audio track and add the subtitles. Open the settings tab here to customize the style of the subtitle. You can change the font style, size, color, alignment, and so on. Below the settings, we have different subtitle styles. I think this one suits the video better. Now, after making all the changes, to download the video together with the subtitles, click on the download option over here. In a few minutes, the video will be ready for download. And that's how you can create an animated video using ChatGPT in Animaker. So go on and give it a try today. If you have any questions, let us know in the comments down below. If you found this video useful, leave a like. And for more such useful videos, subscribe to our channel.